I work at the platforms and services team of Capillary, and I'll be presenting a talk on real-time distributed monitoring, execution, and alert using open source tools, Nagios and Cantrier. So when we started off as a company, we had a small one or two server setup and a LAMP stack, normal. Everything used to happen on the same place. As and when the company grew, the modules went out to a more distributed space and get scattered into different servers which are across different places, which gets difficult to manage. So monitoring becomes very important, because without an idea of that, we cannot know if something is going wrong, if what is going wrong, or if we have to scale in certain direction, how to go about that. So Ganglia is an open source web tool that collects data from different servers and makes it available at a central location. So this is an interface for Ganglia, which shows few system and application level metrics. So like, this is the data collected for application server, MySQL server, our services, and memcache server over a period of a week. And this is the load utilization in that cluster. So this will kind of get red when load utilization is maximum, and be blue when it's zero, green when it's okay too. So it's basically a scalable distributed monitoring system, uses pre-existing tools and technologies that are proven, and builds upon that, like XML, XDR, and RRD2. It uses XML for all kinds of data queries that happen everywhere, uses XDR for portable data transport, and RRD tool for storing the data onto disks. It has many stable and active deployments across the world, and many big sites like Wikipedia, Twitter, Flickr, and whatnot. So what are some of the good features that we'll find in Ganglia? First of all, it's very easy to configure and very easy to integrate with other softwares. We do not need to kind of change configuration every time a new server gets added to the cluster or a new metric gets added to the server, which will get very hectic if you have options like Nagios which need to reconfigure. Other than that, there are lots of open source plugins available which can plug directly into most open source softwares available that we use, MySQL, Apache, Tomcat, and a lot more. And even if that does not meet our requirements, to add metrics is very easy. You can write a simple Python file, or inside any file you can call an executable and send the values. The data store is redundant. It gets stored at multiple different locations wherever you choose in the design. The monitoring daemon is very lightweight, consumes less than 10 MB of RAM and almost no TCP, and it effectively monitors both system and application level metrics, and has plugged in data for many application level metrics, and can be extended to include customized application level metrics for anyone's requirement. And importantly, all of that data is collected centrally and made available at one location, where sense of that data can be made out using different tools.
So
we can develop a plugin in that direction, but what Ganglia does is collects metrics. So metrics are physical quantities which can have numerically representable values. So if you can break down your logs into metrics which have counts which are numerically representable value, you can easily write a script or plugin that can do whatever calculation on your log you want, and in the final step send the value out to the Ganglia server. It's as easy as executing a command, the command with metric name and value. So this is kind of the internal working diagram of Ganglia. It has three major components. So one is gmetad, one is gmond, and the other is the web front. So gmond are the monitoring nodes which run on all the servers that we want to monitor. These are very light nodes these only collect data and send the data to GMetaD. GMetaD collects and aggregates all the data and stores all the all that data onto disk using RRD tool. And the GWeb end accesses the GMetaD data and makes it accessible inside the browser with the page that works.
Pardon?
Okay, the monitoring, it collects data across this distributed system and makes them centrally available. After that, to analyze the data and everything can be done centrally. But distributed in that collection is distributed. So, no deeper into ganglias and turners. The two major pathways of sending metrics to ganglia are the GMonD service and the GMetric executable. So the GMonD service has its own internal scheduler which calls the plugins, and so there'll be like core metrics which are initial system metrics which are loaded by default. Custom plugins can be added to extend the functionality and add new metrics to that. So this scheduler will just call this custom metric and you can define your own function in that to update the logic and to create a new logic. But it will, the scheduling and all will be done by scheduler, and it will collect at different rate intervals and different threshold intervals across different plugins and send data out via UDP directly. It can send via UDP, via TCP and UDP both multicast and unicast. But on most cloud platforms, UDP multicast doesn't work. So UDP unicast is what we use. It picks up its configuration from etcganglia.gmond.com file. That is the file which stores everything that is to configure GMonD. It's a simple one file configuration.
Sorry, but this is installed on every client?
Yeah, this GMonD collection node is installed on every client where we wish to collect.
Does it come with an ACL?
So it kind of does some things with Nagios does and some things with it doesn't, but it's different in its architecture and scales very nice compared to Nagios. Then the next mode of sending data to GMetric is to GMonD is the GMetric executable. It's a simple binary executable which any program can call, giving the name of a metric and the value for a metric, and that metric will immediately show up in the whole system of metrics. So we can have asynchronous data sources which just call that metric. Some data sources we won't know beforehand how often it will happen in an hour or so. Say a log event happens or an error event happens. Can't be included directly into this kind of a plugin. So can directly be included to a GMetric kind of module, but when that happens, GMetric executable can be called with the value and that value will show up live in the whole system. Or if we wish to make small scripts around GMetric, we can have a cron wrapper which does the scheduling. The other end of collection services where all the data coming from GMonD is collected is called the GMetaD service. This also runs as a normal Linux service and has two major ends, the collection and aggregation ends. It collects all the data, sums up data and builds various summary information and then passes the data on to RRD tool to store it in round robin database files. The tool stores it in varweb RRD. Again, GMetaD picks up its configuration from etcganglia.gmetaD.com. GMetaD also has an XML query interface over which all the data that is collected can be accessed and queried. So this is where we can make sense of our centrally collected live data. We can live whatever logic we want to make sense of that. GWeb is one possible option. It's the default web front end that ships with Ganglia to make sense of that data. It gets its metadata from that query interface and gets graphed directly from RRD tools. So the graphs that you saw were just the direct RRD tool and serves the result to the browser. So one other thing which we have over this data is we can connect Nagios to it. So over the system of all the metrics that are being collected across our service farms, this can perform alerts and checks as to if something is going wrong. It can SMS and email immediately if something is wrong. Pardon? How frequently? So it depends on the setting. It's all configurable. You can collect it as frequently as 15, as per every 15 seconds. You can. Pardon? Okay, so it's mostly scalable in all directions. Collection is very scalable. It's very light and uses non-TCP transport. The data gathering and aggregation is also very scalable. The only thing which kind of hits scalability is when the data is being written to disk. So if the server farm scales to say tens of, say thousands of server and tens of thousands of metrics, in that case the disk time will kind of become a bottleneck, because all those metrics will be currently getting written to the disk. Other than that, for that we can have strategies to overcome that, and other than that it scales very nice, and it is used on Wikipedia has like 2,000 to 3,000 server cluster directly on Langley. So if according to the data collected anything is wrong, which are in our logic, Nagios will send us a signal anyway, alerting if something.
No.
So Nagios just runs in a silent mode. It does not connect with any NRP. It just queries this for all the data. All the data is locally available on the same system. These are both running on the same system. So this just collects data, and Nagios we are only using for the alert things. It has no facility for that. But Nagios doesn't scale as well as that. So this is kind of our current deployment phase. So our current servers can be divided into three major categories. Our DB servers, which have a master slave kind of configuration, our app server cluster, and our services servers, which are basically servers which host long running Java services. So on each of these clients, on each of these servers, a GMonD will be installed, will be configured to collect certain metrics. On all DB servers, it will collect all MySQL related metrics or disk IO related metrics. All GMonDs will collect a common set of metrics, but certain metrics will be of more interest for certain servers. So GMonD will collect all DB related metrics. This will collect all Apache related metrics or analyze the log of Apache and produce real time numbers. So and our Java services have JMX exported beans, which have all most of their statistics directly available. So we can directly plug it into our GMonD, and all that metric is available at a central place. So this is our savior, where GMetaD is installed. All these GMonDs send data over UDP to this GMonD. This GMonD collects all that data, and this GMetaD node running here gets all that data from here and writes it to disk or server. Other than that, all of these are in cloud. The mailer is not in cloud, so it can be anywhere. Possible things that might go wrong. One is the point you raised.
So now in the setup we are seeing GMonD leading up to 2 days of
GMonD.
So
GMonD might. Yeah. First of all, Ganglia is in a very active stage of development. So sometimes some memory related bugs get solved. Other than that, GMonD stores all the whole of the store hash. All the servers that are there, GMonD. I've not seen it taking too much time, but its memory gets increased. But in our setup, it doesn't increase that much. But it will store the current data of all the servers' information that it has. GMetaD does not store that, persists that to disk. GMonD has a memory hash for all the servers that are there, so it can be accessed fast. And GMonD is where all this GMetaD gets data from. GMonD stores them in memory, GMetaD pulls that from GMonD and stores them to disk. So disk IO is one of the major things, because all of the other ends are more or less scalable as compared to disk IO. So when a large number of metrics get written on a normal hard disk kind of environment, it will kind of hit. So So what can be done to overcome that? One of the options could be to use a RAM file system, where all the RRD files are stored directly in a RAM file. So disk bottleneck won't be there. But it has the disadvantage that you cannot persist that data. Or you might have redundant setup, one might be persisting data or one might not. RRD cache key has also evolved, which kind of caches all that data that RRD gets and periodically flushes them to disk. So other than that, data retention and resolution. So Ganglia does not retain all the data that it has. By default, more than a year back, it will lose all data. For the current hour, it will keep all data. For the past day, it will keep averages for each hour. Similarly, for past week, it will keep averages for each day. So similarly, the resolution of data kind of changes. This is the configurable property again. If we want, we can configure the RRD tool in such a way that it stores all the data, but that might be memory intensive.
So, can you do it like so? Is it having a single collector, or can you scale down?
Yeah, this number of collectors is scalable. This sends the data out on UDP. Ideally and normally, it sends data out on UDP multicast. So it will just send this data out to all the nodes on the network, whichever want to collect can collect. So, and you might have two nodes monitoring this cluster, and again another cluster which is being monitored by two nodes, and another computer which sits on top of those boot monitoring nodes. That's kind of how it's designed. So like I said, all that data which is available in a single phase can be used in different ways. So one of the first things that is required is to raise alerts when something goes wrong. A distributed system has a lot of interlinked components and modules here and there. A lot of things can go wrong. So to get an idea of what is going wrong and when it's going wrong, if it can be pinpointed out accurately, it's more than half a word then. So we use Nagios for doing that. Nagios has a very good alert system. Our Nagios setup uses local data only, and we have made some custom changes to Nagios as well. So we can set thresholds on metrics across our server farm. We can set thresholds on expression of metrics. Like if say the metrics were load average, 1 minute load, and I wanted to set a threshold of say 1 per CPU, a load of 1 on 1 CPU or 2 on 2 CPU, I want to set such kind of a threshold. So what I can do is directly write an expression, load by CPU count. Both of these are metrics available, and set a threshold on this. And even such complex expressions can be found over all the metrics available across all servers. And even such complex conditionals can be applicable, which are used for a lot of our services. Other than that, Nagios traditionally relies on a framework where you have to kind of go and change config file every time you have to do a change and then reload. So, which is Ganglia does that automatically, so which is only additional trouble for you. So to do that, we move all the configurations we can out of Nagios. One of the basic things we do is name servers uniformly and make regular expression rules in Nagios. So like all DB will be DB servers, all DB can be targeted here this way. If a master comes here, it will be master. And similarly, if an ex DB slave comes up, the rules will be qualified directly. So when Nagios runs on a large cluster, it will when some errors are thrown, it will fail with a lot of errors in some certain cases. So what happens is we'll have to kind of look into all of those errors and find out what is the root cause of the error. Say if MySQL was not running, it will show error as to MySQL is not running, replication on MySQL is not running, and slave lag on MySQL replication is critical. This is a simple case where only MySQL and slave lag are critical. But on a large server, it will show thousands of errors. And to find that what was the root cause of error will be again time taking, and which is not required. So it has a concept of service dependency, which we can directly use on our data. So I'll give you an example of how this works for this simple example. So the first check, all of these checks are natural services, which run on a host and do a service check. The result can be either pass or fail. So the first check that is done is if the Nagios connector, Nagios ganglia connector is working or not. If it's not working, all the other errors should not come out, because it's the most basic level failure. So if it fails, it reports failure and ends, and no other path is got. If this passes, it will go, for this example, this goes to through two paths. First, it goes on the MasterDB server and sees if MySQL is running or not. So we have written a custom kind of collector, so we can find erroneous cases or whatever is not working according to that. It has its own local cache, fileback cache. So if its timestamp is not updating, Ganglia also supplies for all the metrics the freshness of the metric. So if the freshness of the metric is too far off, this thing is not working. So three or four other conditions can come where your local connector is not working. So if the MySQL is not working on DB Master, it will immediately fail, report failure, and report no other failures. If that passes, it goes and checks if the number of threads connected reaches the threshold or not. If it reaches the threshold, it will again fail with report failure. Otherwise, it will pass. The other path is, it will go to the slave and check if MySQL is running or not. Only if MySQL is running will it check for the MySQL replication status. And only if the replication status is okay will it check for the threshold on MySQL slave layer. So in all these cases, the base error gets thrown whenever an error happens. So this gets thrown when this happens. This gets thrown before that. This gets thrown before that. And whenever these errors happen, those errors won't be reported. So we kind of get an idea of the root. So just to give an idea of what our current servers are running a few data. So using some 2000 metrics on some 20 odd servers, the normal Gmondi instances took around 10 MB of RAM, Gmetad took around 4 MB of RAM, and Nagios took around 6 MB of RAM, which is quite less compared to when you scale. And we get alerts within 5 minutes of things going on. I'll now walk you through a small demo about the setup Ganglia. I'll walk you through a small demo of how to set up Ganglia and how easy it is to configure Ganglia. In the meanwhile, if there are questions, I'll just turn my laptop off and reboot into the room. Response time and continuity, what is it?
We
don't use Nagios and NRP and all those solutions to collect data from. Nagios doesn't do any data collection. All the data is. We do Nagios active search. And all that 5 minute and everything is very configurable. It's all open source, so you can change any values to your liking. But if you update your metrics too frequently, you'll again hit this guy earlier. Pardon? Once in a hour, yeah, definitely.
How much ever the period?
Yeah. We have different periods for different types of queries. Some metrics need time to get collected or need computation to get collected. So we don't collect them as frequently as metrics which are just generally available. consent that to as many times. So I have these two demo machines installed. One is demo and one is new demo. Demo has a running instance of Gmondi and Gmetati, and we can check out its Ganglia web front end. Just a default running instance. So these are the preloaded metrics and everything that can be directly visible. This is the overview graph of the memory utilization currently. This is the current CPU utilization. This is the current cluster utilization, but is not visible because it's only a one server cluster. Here all the servers will be visible. Yeah, so all of these graphs can now be zoomed into using drag. So if you leave it, it will zoom to a time frame which is less than. So there'll be various metrics which are corrected for demo. So one plugin which I have installed additionally is Apache Metric, which checks the current state of Apache server, which is running. So all the input. Other than that, CPU metrics are available by default. These are all system metrics which are installed by default. And disk metrics are available by default. So what I'll do is I'll install Gmondi on a new server called new demo and configure it to send data to this place. So I have this pre-made Debian packages which can directly install Debian. Ganglia got installed, now I have to go and configure Ganglia. On our production system, we can have simple scripts which take care of automating all this stuff. So these are two values that I will check and set here. This is the configuration file for Gmondi. All the configurations picked up from here. So, I'll set the host name. And by default, it is configured to send data on multicast, which, like I said, won't work directly on most cloud solutions. So I'll turn off all the multicast like this and add a new send channel to the host that I have Gmetati running, which is demo. So I'll just wait for demo. So a new demo host already shows up here, and soon the metrics for things will appear. The new demo host on which I just installed. only the metric metadata is loaded now, so all values are coming as meta, not a number. All these values will soon appear. So maybe I'll just install another app, the Apache plugin on this thing and check if it's there. I have this plugin here, which is a normal Gmondi plugin. So it has this Python file and the config file. Config file needs to go into the config folder, this book needs to go into the module folder. After that, this plugin will be directly available as a Gmondi plugin. We'll just merge this thing with one. So these basic metrics have started showing up value here. These are the plants which are completed. And these Apache metrics are now coming to show. Now for these Apache metrics, only the metadata has been loaded, so all not a number values are coming here. But it will soon be loaded. In the meanwhile, all the other metrics have started showing up. So I'll just hit the new demo Apache server with multiple requests so that some values get shown there. These values have started to appear, 1 year, 5 year, file threads and basic threads. And we'll soon all get updated as a database. So that's about it from me. If there are no questions.